Before we do all that, we've got someone in our audience, in the studio, who's involved with education. And I asked her to come by because I think what she does in education is very unique. And it may be very informative to you. For those of you, you know how upset we are about the cost of student loans. And you know that Obama is in a battle with this conservative House Republicans on interest rates for college students. And many of you, if you think about it, the income of women in this country, data has shown that because of discrimination in pay against women, that when you compare what women invest in education, many of them, it takes them years to get a return. We talk about many, many years to get a suitable return on that investment. And for men, that investment takes place a lot quicker. So, you know, we have issues in this country, like women are making 77 cents for every dollar a man makes. So when you think about the issue of college education, women are making the investment and women are trying and women are taking on these loans, but a lot of them are struggling. All right. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce my guest. She's with an organization called Degrees of Success or Degree of Success. I'm sure she'll correct me. Anyway, her name is Jen Dobson. Jen, welcome to the Sunday Forum.
Hi, thank you.
Hey, it's good to have you.
Thank you. It's nice to be here.
Jen, tell us a little bit about what is Degrees of Success?
Well, Degrees of Success is a company that I put together about 3.5 years ago. Mm-hmm. And what I do is I help students and those that have graduated manage their debt. And the problem is that usually what happens is that the information is not given to them as far as what their options are. Mm-hmm. There was a study that was done about a year and a half ago that talks about, you know, with Obama's, Education Act that he put together mm-hmm. in 2007, 900,000 people qualify for a reduced monthly payment, mm-hmm. but don't take advantage of it because most of them don't even know they exist.
Wow.
So he's put into place a lot of these different programs, IBR programs, a new ICRA program. There's a pay-as-you-earn program, but nobody knows it exists.
Okay.
And so what my company does is I go in and I educate, and I help fill out paperwork, and I help talk to lenders, call Sally Mae, call Department of Education, and make sure that my clients have these programs in place to keep them out of default,
mm-hmm.
keep them from having their credit destroyed because they simply did not fill out the right paperwork.
I see. All right. So if folk want to get in, need help from somebody like you, can they call you?
Absolutely. Anybody can call me. Best number to reach me is going to be 813-528-1102. And I also, of course, have an email, which is gdobson@degreesofsuccessinfo.com. And my website is www.degreesofsuccessinfo.com.
Okay. Again, if you want to get a hold of you, to give that phone number one more time.
Sure. Phone number 813-528-1102.
All right. When I talked to Jen before the show, I said, Jen, I want you to be very brief because we got a lot of stuff planned on the show today. But Jen, allow me to pivot for a second and ask you a much more personal, but I guess economic question also.
Sure.
I was talking earlier about the fact that women in this society make 77 cents for every dollar a man makes. Black women, and you are a black woman, black women make 69 cents for every dollar a man makes. And Latino women make 60 cents for every dollar a man makes. I haven't had a professional black woman in my studio for a while, so I want to take advantage of you for the next 3 minutes or so.
Of course.
And ask you this, because I remember how I met you. I met you at a forum, and you were actually talking about how difficult it is for a single professional black woman with a child, you know, to make it in this society.
Absolutely.
Last week, before you start, because I'm going to have her on, I was watching the Miami Heat game at a sports bar, and one of the waitresses there is a working class white female who I'm gonna have her on the show too, because she was telling me about how difficult it is to be a working class white female in this society. But since I got you here today, talk to me a little bit about it. I want to share that with people because I'm sure you are well dressed.
extremely well dressed. You got your jewelry.
Thank you.
You travel. You're worldly. You're well read. You're a professional woman. So most people would look at you and say, you don't have no problems.
I wish that was true. I wish that was true. It is very difficult, you know, being a woman, and then being a black woman. Mm-hmm. So you have, you know, the sexism and the racism that you have to deal with. Mm. And then on top of that, I am a single mom. So juggling, you know, my household, you know, I own a house, which is a struggle, you know, doing, you know, things around the house and then taking care of my son and then, you know, running my own business and being a female, mm-hmm. I'm not looked at the same as a man going out and talking to other people about debt management. I'm looked at as a female.
Wow.
And I have to work three times as hard, I feel, to actually get through to people that, yes, I know this stuff. Mm-hmm. You know, give me a chance. I know that I'm a female, but I work very hard. And you're absolutely right when it comes to the cost of education, putting that money in, and I did as well. I went to college and graduated. The cost of education and then turning around and not making as much, it's not fair. Mm-hmm. And fortunately for me, starting my own business, now I can essentially pay myself mm-hmm. what I feel like I deserve. But prior to that, working in corporate America as a woman, you're not respected the same. You're not given the same when it comes to money. And it's not fair, mm-hmm. you know, to put the same amount in with regards to education and not get the same out.
You know, I often talk to my, I was counting my years since I'm a young man. Mm-hmm. I was counting the number of years that I've actually worked at an executive level just last week. And I was thinking how much I learned. And I remember always thinking, but I'm never given credit for how much I've learned in all those years. And people are always treating me. I swear to God, people not believe this here. This is a true statement. I have never been on a job, even as an executive, that eventually somebody didn't try to put the secretary in charge of me.
Right.
In charge of my whereabouts, watching where I go, where I go, when I come back in the office, watching my timesheet. Give them such authority. After a while, I've had secretaries that come up to me and start talking to me like they supervise me. And this has happened to me on several jobs.
Right.
People don't understand these little dehumanizing parts
Absolutely.
Of us being black professionals. And I talk about this stuff and people don't think that stuff happens. So what are some of the things you've seen internally that just, it just makes you sick on the stomach?
Oh, I've experienced so much when it comes to that in corporate America. Just like you said, being dehumanized, you know, being watched over by somebody who's, you know, essentially under you, mm-hmm. but still treating you as if you're not good enough to even be there.
Mm-hmm.
And as a woman and as a black woman, you get that all of the time. You know, like you said, bathroom breaks. I mean, you're going to count down how many minutes I went to the restroom.
Mm-hmm.
You know, things like that, that it's just not fair that our society still deals with that. And nobody should have to. And a job mm-hmm. that about a year and a half ago, prior to me actually running my business full time that I worked at, they treated people really bad, especially women. You know, women were talked down to, women were yelled at. We were never respected in the office. And we're talking educated women. Some of these women had master's degrees and they were treated like, you know, second class citizens.
Mm-hmm. I work with other executives, executive level. I mean, they on the way to lunch, on the way back from work, they would stop to the cleaners. They stop. They have power lunches, and sometimes the power lunches take 2 hours. It didn't matter what it take to get the deal done.
Mm-hmm.
But people view me as having 1 hour for lunch at an executive level. Mm-hmm. It's just unbelievable what we go through.
Right.
You know, and it's difficult to explain to people who've never been through it. Some of the privileges that we assume that comes with the job and the position, we can't assume those privileges.
Absolutely not. Well, we're not trusted.
Yeah. And I've been on jobs, Jen, I tell you, where the people who working with me and working below me have been told by the people above me, don't share that much information with them. Don't let them know what's going on. And there's always a grapevine. They talk about being black in corporate America. There's always a grapevine that you're not a part of.
Right. Exactly.
So things come down from the executive office that they know that you don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Policy decisions have changed you don't know.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they run the data and the goals and the mission of change that you're the last to know. And you still got to keep up with all of that, figure it out for yourself,
exactly.
And still run the same race. And you better be ahead at the end of that race.
Absolutely. And don't mess up.
And don't mess up. I tell young people, and I hate to put this burden on young people, but Arthur Ashe said, take this burden of race and wear it as a cloak of dignity. Not only don't mess up, but don't even appear
right.
to mess up.
Absolutely.
That's all it takes.
Absolutely.
You don't have to mess up, just even appear that you might mess up. So anyway, listen, I want to thank you for coming by.
Thank you.
And if you don't mind, you hang around and kind of check us out.
Absolutely.
Yeah, we do crazy radio here. So I thank you. I think you'll enjoy. Jack, let's take a brief pause.